Okay. Good afternoon, class. And now we have already seen just some minimum level introduction to the managerial economics and financial analysis. Okay. Now in the introduction, we have seen I have asked a question for you. Imagine for a while if you have finished your studies and you have joined as an engineer in a manufacturing organization, what to do, what do you do? I've asked such type of question for you, and we are in the discussion of that, right? Okay, generally what you will be doing if you are an engineer in a manufacturing organization, you will be planning to produce a maximum quantity of goods of a given quality at a reasonable cost. Okay, anytime you will be thinking of that, we have to produce the quantity, and that means we have to produce the goods with a reasonable cost, and we should have the required quality of the goods. Okay, now, and also on the other hand, if you go through that, if you are a sales manager, what do you have to do? You have to sell the maximum amount of goods with a minimum advertisement cost. Okay, you have to sell a maximum amount of goods with a minimum advertisement cost. Okay, and also in other words, what you have to do is you have to minimize your cost. You have to minimize your cost, and you have to maximize your returns. And by doing so, you are practicing the principles of managerial economics. Do you get now? Okay. Now, we'll see this. Managers, what to do, what they will be doing in day-to-day life. What are their day-to-day activities? You'll see once. Okay, managers, their day-to-day activities is to confronted with the several issues, such as how much quantity is to be supplied. If you are a manager or if an engineer in a manufacturing industry, you should see that you should see that how much quantity has to be supplied. For example, if you see you are a bike manufacturing industry, if you are a manager in a bike manufacturing industry, and you will be getting the demand from different distributors, and you should be able to supply those required bikes in the specified amount of time. Do you get now? First, as a manager, you should know how much quantity is to be supplied. How many number of bikes has to be supplied corresponding distributors, and at what price you have to supply, and should the product be made internally or whether it should be brought from the outside. What does it mean here? To produce a bike, we require some amount of inputs such as iron ore, alloy, or many others, tires, okay, any other required if necessary. Okay, we have different types of concepts called as if your company is a starting one, you will be getting the tires from outside. If your company is a very big one and you are selling more number of bikes, you will be thinking that instead of getting the bike tires outside, better to manufacture it by your company. These things you have to take decision. In that case, that whether it should be brought from outside or it has to be made internally. Okay. how much quantity is to be produced to make a given amount of profit and so on. If you are a manager, the company CEO or else the proprietor of the company will be giving you some target. I have to get this much amount of profit by the end of March or by the end of June. Say some December like this. Generally, generally, a financial year is divided into four quarters, starting from the April, May, June will be treated as first quarter, and July, August, September will be treated as second quarter. October, November, December is treated as third quarter, and January, February, March will be treated as the fourth quarter. Do you get now? 3 months makes a quarter for a financial year. Okay, the manager will be getting some targets saying that, so for the first quarter, you have to earn this much amount of profit by the CEOs. Our CEOs are also the proprietor of the companies where you work. Okay, you should have this concept. If you study this managerial economics and financial analysis properly, you will be in a position to get the required amount of profit also. Okay, or you will be in a position to manage all the things whichever necessary in a company. Okay, here manager economics provides us the basic insight into seeking solutions for managerial problems. As I said, we have different types of problems, right? Just identifying how much quantity is to be supplied and at what price, and should the product be made internally or whether it has to be brought from outside, or how much quantity is to be produced to make a given amount of profit and so on. As an example, if you have seen the bike industry, if the CEO's target is some amount of money, you should be able to calculate to get that much amount of profit, how many number of bikes has to be produced and at what price you have to sell that. And to get, you can get that particular specified amount of profit. Okay. So, you have to have the knowledge of this managerial economics. So I am saying that managerial economics, it is consisting of two distinct disciplines. One is economics and other one is the management. Okay, it is, in other words, we can say it is necessary for us to learn the basic aspects, what economics is and what management is, in brief, right? So see here, what economics you see here.
On the cake.
Thank you.
Economics is a study of human activity, both at individual and the national level. Do you get now? First, our main title of the subject is managerial economics and financial analysis. In the first part, we are seeing managerial economics. And managerial economics is nothing but two disciplines, right? One is economics and one is management. Now we are seeing individually what economics is first. Later we will be see what management or what a manager has to do, right? You see here now what economics is. Economics is the study of human activity, both at individual and national level. In the school level itself, in the social studies, we have studied. The economics as a particular part of social studies. Now, just we'll see, we recall those once. economics is a study of human activity both at the individual and the national level. Economics if you, just if an example if you see in your bike you can see economy in the speedometer. What does it mean? If you go in that particular amount of speed, generally it will be showing in the range of 30 to 50. If you are driving your bike in the speed of in the range of 30 to 50, you will be getting more amount of mileage. Economy, right? That means that is called as economy drive. Economy drive in the sense you are saving the petrol, automatically you are saving the money, right? Do you get the example? Economy is nothing but saving money. Okay. Here it can be done as for an individual, or it can be done as a national level. Indian economy. We used to hear these type of words in the news. Okay, our Indian economy is going to rise, or our Indian economy is going to drop, or our Indian economy is in the steady state. Okay, generally most of the other countries has seen recessions many number of times. The topmost countries also has seen the recession, but India has not seen the recession as other countries has seen. It has a very strong economy. Okay, it has a very strong economy. We have see here, I am changing the modes of the word economics, right? Okay, economist is the person who is pioneer in the economics. Okay, here the economist of early ages treated economics merely as a science of wealth. Okay, they have treated this economics as purely it's a science of wealth. Okay, the reason is clear here. Every one of us is involved in effort of aiming at earning money and spending this money to satisfy our wants such as food, clothing, shelter and others. So every one of us are aware of economy. How? You can see if you are earning a money of rupees 10,000 per month, you have to spend below the 10,000 only. If you are spending more than that, you have to take loan from others. If you are unable to manage the money what you are having or what you are earning, you have to go for some other loans and paying the interest. So in our day-to-day life, your mother and your father are economists, what you can see. Okay, your mother or father, either one will be earning or both will be earning, and they used to manage with the money what they get, right? They are managing with the money what they get, and they are satisfying your requirements. Okay, for example if your father is earning at most 50,000 rupees per month, he has some idea of saving some amount for your studies, some amount for food needs, some amounting for clothing needs, some amount for shelter in the sense you may be having your own house, or you may be in the rented house. If you are having own house and if you have to pay the house loan, he'll be setting some amount of within place pay that house. That means that house rent or house loans. And you can see that you should have the idea, or else he will be having the idea what are the minimum requirements in our day-to-day life. Generally the food, clothing, shelter and all other minimum level requirements are our requirements. Okay, if your father is earning 50,000 per month and you have an intention of buying a very big car, a Rolls Royce or a Land Rover or any other thing, the money what you earn will not be sufficient. The money what you earn will not be sufficient for your general needs also. Buying that car and keeping aside and going for one or two trips, and you can't satisfy your general needs such as food, clothing, shelter and other. That means you are analyzing, or you are able to know what are the main first priority, food, clothing, shelter and others, or later you will be going for a little bit luxurious such as bike or some other aspects, say some washing machine or else some other AC, these types of requirements. Your earnings decides your luxuries or else your minimum requirements. So all these activities what I have said right now, they are the economic activities only. Okay, you should be clear that how much you earn, how much you spend. Okay, how much you earn and how much you spend. In our India, in our country, everyone is an economist. Everyone is having the habit of saving money. Mostly 90% of the people who live in India, or else our Indians, will be having this habit of saving money for future if any problem persists. Okay, what to do? Okay, they will be using the amount what they have saved. Okay, these type of aspects are there. So everyone is an economist. So just go through the slide. In 18th century itself, Adam Smith, the father of economics, defined economics as the study of nature and use of the national wealth. So as I said, economics is nothing but study of human activity and also the national level. And at the national level, in the starting days itself, the economy of a country depends upon the national wealth. Okay, we used to have different types of resources such as iron resource, gold resources, or coal, or any others. Okay, that means our economy, the Indian economy, the national level economy used to depend on these aspects. Okay, next, go for the next slide. See, we have the definition, previous definition in the 18th century. In the 19th century, we have another definition by Dr. Alfred Marshall, one of the greatest economists of 19th century. He is saying that economics is a study of man's action in the ordinary business of life. He is saying that life is also one type of business. It's ordinary business of life. It inquires how he gets his income and how he uses it. Okay, as I said in the previous example, if your father or mother or your total family income is around in the range of 50,000, and you will be knowing how you will be spending, you should know how you have to spend your 50,000. Okay, whether the requirements is necessary requirements or else it's a luxurious requirements. If you go for luxurious requirements, it means if you think as that having a very high end car as your main basic need. If the money what you have earned will be going for the loan, car loan only. You can't eat anything. You can't have the basic needs also. Okay, you should be able to identify that. You should be able to identify that. So here, in the 19th century, Dr. Alfred Marshall said that economics is the study of man's actions in the ordinary business of life, and it inquires how he gets his income and how he uses it. Okay, thus it is one side, and study of wealth, and on the other, more important side is the study of man. So he is saying that it is both human study of wealth and also the study of man's behavior. Actually, as Marshall observed, the chief aim of economics is to promote the human welfare, but not the wealth. Okay, his main aim is to promote the human welfare, but not the wealth. And S. Pigou, he had given some other definition also by accepting what the Marshall has said. Okay, S. Pigou, he also accepted the what Dr. Alfred Marshall has said, and he has given the other definition for the economics as: it's the study of economic welfare that can be brought directly and indirectly into the relationship with the measuring rod of money. What he is saying, it is economic, a study of economic welfare that can be brought directly or indirectly into the relationship with the measuring rod of money. Here he is saying that whatever the case may be, you will be, it is related to the money only. He is saying that. Here comes the other one, Professor Robbins. He defined economics as: it's the science which studies human behavior as a relationship between the ends and scary means. That means lack of resources, very few resources, you can say. Okay, scarcity, scarcity. You can get that scarcity. Pronunciation we heard of the scarcity. It is not scarcity. Scary means which have alternative uses. Okay, when we have very less abundant of resources, we should be able to manage with the resource what we have. Okay, you should be able to manage with the limited amount of resources. Then only we will be able to know how perfect we are, how we are able to manage the things, whether we are able to manage or not, we will be identifying there. Okay. With this, the focus of economics has shifted from wealth to the human behavior. What he is saying, what Robbins is saying is, if you are having very less amount of resources, you should be able to know. You should be able to know that how to manage that with limited amount of resources. Okay, Lord Keynes. He also defined economics as the study of administration of limited means or limited resources, and determinants of employment and income. Okay, if you are a good economist and we have a company, and you should be able to manage with the given number of employees. Okay, you have seen this definition what had said. Now, as a part of economics, we can go with the what microeconomics is and what macroeconomics is, and we also had a new term, welfare economics. First, we'll see what microeconomics is. The study of individual consumer. This is the study of an individual consumer or a firm is called as microeconomics. This is also called as theory of firm. Microeconomics, that is nothing but if you are studying a single consumer, that means if you are seeing your family budget, how you earn the money, how you spend the money of your family itself, or if you have a company and if you see particularly of that particular firm only, it is called as microeconomics. It is also called as theory of firm. Firm means a single company or single firm or single company. Okay, do you get now? It is, and if it is an individual consumer or else if it is of individual company, it is called as a theory of firm or else micro, it is part of microeconomics. Firm is different and industry is different. For example, Maruti Suzuki is a one car manufacturing firm. Okay, and in the same way we have Hyundai, or else some other companies say Tata. Okay, some other Mahindra. They are in the car industry. Do you get now what a firm is and what a industry is? Car industry, bike industry. When you see the news, you can say the car industry has good profits in this quarter, or else the bike industry has a good profits in this quarter. Do you get now? When we talk individually a particular company, it is a firm. Okay, do you get now? So now if you see regarding a company or singly individually about your family, it is called as an microeconomics. Micro means 1 millionth, that means 10 to the power of minus 6. Okay, 10 to the power of minus 6. Here this microeconomics deals with the behavior and the problem of single individual and of micro organization. Okay, microeconomics deals with the behavior and the problem of single individual and of micro organization. Managerial economics has its roots in microeconomics and it deals with the micro or individual enterprise. It is concerned with the application of the concepts such as price theory, law of demand, and other theories of market structure and so on. Okay, if you see the microeconomics, that means if you are studying a single firm economy, it will be having different types of concepts in it as a part of managerial economics, such as law of demand and theories of market structure and so on. Okay, so here if you go with the macroeconomics, it's the study of aggregate of total level of economic activity in a country is called as macroeconomics. Okay, so it may be studying in the national wide. If you are studying regarding a car industry, it is nothing but the macro economics. Okay. Now you see this. We are in the macroeconomics. The study of aggregate of total level of economic activity in a country is called as macroeconomics. It studies the flow of economic resources of factors of production, such as we have different factors of production. We can call them as land, labor, capital, organization, and technology. Okay. We have some economic resources. We can also call this as factors of production. When we study this macroeconomics, we will be thinking of all these factors such as land, labor, capital, organization, and the technology. And from the resource one or two, the business streams, and then for the business streams to the households. Okay, you don't get confused of this. Okay, it's a study of flow of economic resources of our factors of production. It's called as macroeconomics. Okay. So when we think regarding the national level economics, we have to think regarding different aspects, such as total aggregates. For instance, if you see total national income and total employment, output and total investment. Okay, all these aspects has to be seen, and the studies that are interrelation among the various aggregates and examines their nature and the behavior that demand. Okay, we will be continuing from macroeconomics in the next class. Okay, we will be continuing from the macroeconomics in the next class.